Hello, welcome to Liberica Bar, small talks about Java and OpenJDK in an informal way. Today we are going to discuss the checklists for switching from Oracle JDK to OpenJDK as an example on Liberica JDK. That is why today we met with Alexander Belokrylov, the CEO of BellSoft. And Alexander, could you please tell us, is it true that it's very hard to migrate from Oracle JDK to OpenJDK? It's connect a lot of people and have a lot of problems with it.
Hello, Alice. Hello, everybody. I wouldn't say that it's really hard to migrate from Oracle JDK to OpenJDK if we know exactly what we do, as in any other areas.
Do you have some type of algorithm or main points of switching from Oracle JDK to OpenJDK? Let's tell our followers about it.
Yeah, absolutely. I would say that there are several areas what organization need to understand, know, and check. And the first area is the version of Oracle JDK what we use. We need to understand whether we use some outdated old versions of Oracle JDK, JDK 6 or JDK 7. For such organizations, I would strongly recommend to move to JDK 8, because moving to JDK 8 from older versions will take less time. And JDK 8 will be supported until 2031 by BellSoft, and it is like pretty strong investment. However, BellSoft supports JDK 6 and JDK 7 together with modern versions of OpenJDK. The organizations which are on JDK 8, which are the dominant part of organizations around the world now, are safe to migrate to OpenJDK as is from version to version. We haven't seen any issues with that. And the organizations which use the feature releases, which are migrating, already migrating to the most modern versions of OpenJDK, are absolutely safe. And the next area which need to be checked is whether organization use any like desktop or servers. If server Java exists within organizations, that's one question. If the Java works on desktops, this requires some additional attention for migration. The companies need to understand whether we do have some applications which requires web start support or applets, or we do need a JavaFX. In that cases, for web start, we are in collaboration with Karakun and offers an open web start within together with Liberica JDK.
What about their architectures?
Architectures, yeah. Of course, the easiest way for migration will be for microservices architectures, which use the Dockerization, Docker containers. We just need to replace a Docker container with Oracle JDK to the Docker container with or OpenJDK. For example, Liberica JDK is available on Docker Hub. For companies which use monolith applications with open source servers as Tomcat, this shouldn't be a problem also. I see that companies which use proprietary application servers as WebLogic or WebSphere or some GBoss, in that case, it's not reasonable to migrate to OpenJDK because support of the vendor JDK, Oracle Java, and G9 already included in the offering of application server support. And moving out the vendor's runtime, Oracle Java, for example, out of WebLogic would harm your support contract. So Oracle will not provide support for WebLogic without Oracle Java place.
And should they always need to pay money for Oracle?
Such organizations already pay for application servers, which already include support for Java.
Is there any other situations where the client can't migrate from Oracle to OpenJDK?
Possibly there are some situations we don't know, but generally we haven't met any other situations than Oracle customers could not migrate to OpenJDK.
How could they choose a distribution? Is there any factor that we should know about?
How to decide on OpenJDK distribution? This is a very good question. There are several distribution providers on the market, and BellSoft is one of support providers for OpenJDK. We provide OpenJDK binary called Liberica JDK. And here organizations need to understand what architectures we want to be supported, whether they want to use OpenJDK in some like cloud environments, for example. BellSoft provides some additional advantages for cloud use of OpenJDK. We do provide the smallest Docker container in the world, that Alpha and Linux. And we created a JDK enhancement proposal to make support of Alpha and Linux upstream of OpenJDK, which will be integrated, which should be integrated in JDK 16, the next version of OpenJDK. And this would bring the value to the customers by using this small, very, very, very tiny container with JDK, but still standard compliant, standard verified Docker container.
Yeah, I got it about benefit of Liberica, but once again, could you tell maybe two main points of choosing a distribution of OpenJDK? A distributor of OpenJDK, yep.
I wouldn't say that, first of all, the organization need to understand what versions of JDK supported by a support provider, like whether we need older version, like JDK 6 and JDK 7, and check if the support provider provided. Next, we need to understand what architectures we need to have supported by OpenJDK runtime. Some organizations need to support Solaris, for example, or PowerPC, or ARM servers, which are getting more and more popular, as we see. We need to check whether the support provider provides ports for these architectures. Next, we need to see if support provider provides the JavaFX if they need it, or the web start is supported by the support provider. So there are number of criteria how organizations are making decisions about that. And our checklist is actually helping organizations to go through some like path many other organizations already went to, and make a decision pretty quickly which part of their infrastructure could be easily migrated to OpenJDK and which part is better to keep on Oracle JDK or like vendors JDK.
Well, thank you, Alexander. It's a nice algorithm. I think it could help a lot of your clients. Let's send these chat links to our viewers. You can just photo this QR code and we will send you the checklists about migration from Oracle JDK to OpenJDK. Well, thank you for this interview, Alexander. Let's discuss in the next episode something more details about high-powered support of BellSoft and some other teams. I think it will be interesting topics for our followers.
Thanks a lot, Alice, for the invitation. Thanks a lot, everybody. Bye-bye.
Bye.